Whatever you want is the story, of course. You know this by now.
The usual, I see.
Actually, I am the definition of unusual, at least from the point of view of the reality you people like to think you're in control of. Diablo shook his head. There was no way he was getting drawn into another one of Billy Pronto's dialogues. Diablo felt that he got along in life pretty serenely until whenever Billy Pronto showed up and turned him into an ill-tempered and cynical grouse. He decided to remain silent until he arrived at his destination. To his inevitable aggravation, however, this did not seem to upset Billy Pronto in the least. Diablo was doubly aggravated when, upon parking, Billy Pronto actually followed him out of the truck, leaving his present behind.
"Where do you think you're going?"
Diablo demanded, and a passing woman with impossibly long harvest brown hair streaked sexy with a few strands of silver heard his rhetorical inquiry as if it were intended for her. She stopped long enough for Diablo to catch a smirk from the "Argue Naked" emblazoned across the front of her t-shirt, hesitantly touched the side of her nose, and changed her direction, whispering, "Walk away," to herself. An hour later, she happened to run into her estranged boyfriend, over whom she'd wept because of their separation just that morning. Both of them discovered a transcendental sexuality that night, but their love is for another story, a story of love and other pranks.
"You need me for this," Billy Pronto answered. "I need you for what?"
"You need me for what you are about to do."
"What am I about to do?"
Billy Pronto stopped. They were standing in front of a bookstore, the same bookstore Elizabeth had yesterday wandered into. Billy Pronto pointed to the door.
"Walk in there, find a random book, open it to a random page, and read the words that your eyes fall upon." "Why would I do that?"